I will leave you with this. My favorite thing that ever happened at Best Week Ever happened in the old multi-panelist days when there was a bunch of us sitting in front of the construction paper. Now, when we shot that show, we were not in an actual TV studio. The show was very cheap to produce. We were in an office building, and our studio, as it was in this disused office, tiny little space. There was just enough room for the camera, the comedian, and the construction paper. Next to us, we shared a wall with a totally different show, the I Love The series of programs. I love the 70s, I love the 80s, I love the 90s. This is where a totally different group of comedians would sit in front of totally different construction paper, and they would wax comedic about a bygone decade. Like they would hold up a Rubik's Cube and say, ha, remember, and then put it back down again. That one still runs sometimes. So because we were not in an actual TV studio, we did not have the soundproofing that comes along with such a TV studio. And so us and the other TV show, we could hear each other through the wall. Now, you know how when you watch Law & Order, you don't also hear Scrubs? That's on purpose. It enhances the viewing. So there was no etiquette in place for this situation, which was never supposed to exist. So in the absence of any etiquette, how to handle this, we evolved, without speaking a word, we evolved our own rule about this, which was, whichever TV show got there first, they had the right to complain about the other TV show, and the other TV show had to take it. So if I Love the 90s got there first, and we were too loud, they could hear us through the wall, I Love the 90s got to come over and say, you guys, would you keep it down? We're trying to do a TV show over there. And then we had to go, oh, sorry, we were just trying to do a TV show over here. Dumb. So one day, Best Week Ever is there first. We have the right of complaint. I Love the 80s starts to get too loud. One of our crew members goes next door to tell them to shush. He comes back. And he's giggling, and he says, oh my God, guess who's over there? It's Weird Al Yankovic. And I said, oh man, next time they get too loud, let me go over there. I've met Weird Al through comedy. I'll make a big bit out of it, you know, just over the top yelling, and everybody will relax, and it'll diffuse the tension. It'll be a lot of fun. Look, I still have to tell the story. Few minutes goes by, they start to get loud again. I'm like, here I go. This is gonna be great. Now I need you to know that what I'm about to do for you now is exactly the way I did it back then. I am not exaggerating at all. I kick the door in. I fix my gaze on Weird Al and I say, Weird! You have got to keep it down! Just like that. Weird Al says, oh, I know, somebody already came over here once. I'm so sorry. I hope he didn't ruin a take or anything. I think, okay, he did not seem to understand that I was kidding around. Thought it was pretty obvious. I don't want to make him feel bad, so I'm going to have to go a little farther over the top with this one. So it's obvious my intent, which is fun. So I wind up, and I go just like this. I mean, Weird! You are killing us over there! Just like that. Weird Al responds, ugh, I know, I'm so embarrassed. I just got carried away, I guess, and I didn't realize how loud I was being. I'm so sorry. This must be frustrating for you. And I think, does he not hear that I'm calling him weird? So I think, okay, I don't see how this is going wrong. I need to try this again. Gotta really dig deep, really swing for the fences on this one. Because my goal is fun. It's not to make Weird Al feel bad. So, all right, I'm going to have to go so over the top on this one, there can be no mistaking my intent. And somebody so over the top that if somebody 50 yards from here were to glance in this direction, their only thought would be, they're having fun over there. Okay, here we go. Here we go. Time to really sell it, really sell it. Super huge over the top. So I go, I mean, weird! You have got to put a sock in it! And that's when I realize I have never met Weird Al in my life. I've seen him on TV like everybody else has. And now I am yelling in his face. So Weird Al says, I'm so sorry. I'm so sorry. I promise I will keep it down. So of course, at that point, I say, see that you do! And I ran away. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you so much. Thank you all for coming out tonight. You guys are fantastic. Thank you for having me back, Brooklyn. Thank you so much. Until we meet again, thank you. Good night.